press the horse onto the left foreleg. So as you progress with bending exercises, shoulder and that collection, we are still pulling the horse onto the inside rein. So you have to try to begin to change your arm, and your inside rein should go more towards his mane while you use it. And what that means is you shorten your inside saddle towards his mane, and you can use your hand, but you're going to turn it over instead of pull it back to your thigh. And you're going to keep it in front of the swell. It still is really in front of the swell. And your hands should be about no more than 5 inches apart, because it's not wider than the bit or you're pulling out. So, should I have back rotation while I warm up? That's what you just asked me. Think about what you asked me. Should I have bad rotation? Should you be in a chair seat? Should you be behind the vertical? Should you look down? If this is your correct hand position, if this is the hand position that riders should ride in, can't you learn to ride in this position and warm it up? That's what you're asking me. Really, that's what you're asking me, aren't you? You're saying, can I learn to ride in this position while I warm up? You can if you want to. If you understand why I'm asking you to do it, can you get it deep? Can you get it round? Can you get it to stretch in the correct equitational position for you? Yes, if you want to. No, if you don't. Because you have to, I can't convince you to do anything right here. That's up to you. You have to understand what I'm asking you to do and why. And then you're going to have to change what you do. And you can do it if you want to.
I just feel at times that I sort of have to open up that inside to let his shoulder have a place to go for a moment.
Right, but the other thing is do you have to bend his neck all the time? No. And do you need, and what I'm trying to teach you is that if you open your hand for a moment, that you don't carry it there. You're capable of doing that. You can move your hand and bring it back to the right position, and move your hand and bring it back to the right position. Because it's the thing where you see trainers that kick horses all the time. What they did was they taught the horse, they trained the horse to an incorrect aiming of itself. They wanted a heavier leg, they used a heavier leg, they don't ever use a lighter leg, so we didn't train. So all we need to do is if you keep trying to triangulate your arms, you will train your horse to this position. And this position is more effective going forward long term for you. And the more that you can teach yourself to do this, the more effective you'll be. Can riders warm horses up in this equitational position? Yes, because this is the correct position. But I mean, I understand, like, it's nutty to go to a clinic and a clinician says, hey, what did you change this? I remember, I was with arthritis the first time he asked me to do this. I thought I was going to pull my freaking hand. Most important properties is how the horse develops, how they step the first step into the shoulder end. And this has to do not with judging problem, it's training, and it has to do with the rider trainer's control of the horse. So all of the lateral movement, the shoulder end, on there, the hunches in, is all about, can you get into bend but keep him on the same line? So have him halt for just a second so you can see what I'm... You know, when you're in Germany, they talk to you a lot about this. I don't hear it a lot in America unless you go to Kathy Conway, Betsy Steiner. Bo Jennes does it here, but he's a Swedish Olympic coach. Ben Akhtakadas. It's good for people with old-fashioned European training talk about this, but I don't hear anybody, none of the modern trainers are talking about this, but it's really important, and it's important in Western dressage because our trainers were trained, you know, like Gail Harf Carmona's on the education committee. Man, she's old-fashioned. So here's what's happening for you. If a horse tracks along like this, so he's not using that part of the track, but he's tracking along right here. What should happen is the first step that this foot goes out here. So his right foot is still here, and his outside front foot comes here, which means that the inside front foot is going to come here. Are you still with me? I know this is really simple, but I don't know any other way to explain it to you. What's happening for you is when you go to put your horse into the tracks, he gets closer to the wall. And he goes like this, and then this foot goes here. So he actually gets closer to the wall. He falls out as he goes into the three tracks. Now, once you get the three tracks, it's great, it's lovely, it's uphill. But right there, that wasn't engagement because he fell out. And how you got that was that you put the inside gates on, which shoved it closer to the wall. Does that make sense?
Uh-huh.
One of the things you're trying to do is control the outside hind leg. And that wasn't it because he got closer to the wall. Now it's the same thing in the haunches in, that as he is coming in, you're doing lovely haunches in, except that as he does it, he gets closer and closer to the wall with his front feet.
Okay.
And the whole thing about these exercises is that whatever legs are supposed to track in the track that they're in, they're supposed to maintain that exact line. Now, is this picky? Yes. But you have a really good horse. You're a super good rider, and you need to really understand that you didn't make engagement. You disengaged him to start, then you did this trick, exercise, movement, but you didn't. It's like you fried an egg, you dropped it on the floor, and you put it on the plate. You did it, it's cooked, they can eat it, but you shouldn't have done that.
Okay.
Okay? So I just want you to understand what's happening with these really good marks, because I know that you're going to go out there and they're going to give you really good marks.
So,
but there's a difference between you getting a good mark and you being a good trainer.
So let me show you going this way. So this is my stronger leg on the outside now.
Probably good.
So this one.
You don't have trouble with this one?
I don't know. I don't
okay.
Know.
All right. I'm going to stand over here and look at it.
I can clean it up easier on this side and then translate to the other side.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because like my left leg pops me.
Okay. Your right leg and shoulder is the part of the head.
Yeah, I do. I mean, I have a lot of loss on this side in general.
Okay. All right, I'm
going
to stand over here in the corner so that I can sure know what you did. Yeah, because you were trying so hard not to fall out, you fell in. But the beginning was correct, and then you fell in. Come towards me down there again, that's fine. So you had the right side foreleg, which cowboys think is the hind legs,
and it's not, because what he has to do is he has to pick his thoracic up in order to cross his leg.
Okay.
So the next part is that his hind legs have to work, that his outside leg has to cross ahead. So as you keep him in connection, you have to be sure that he's not thinking backwards.
Is the pivot, so if I'm going to pivot to the left, would his flexion be to the left?
Yes.
And is it still walking or beats? Or
pivots do not have a walk beat because the hind legs don't, they don't maintain the sequence of the walk behind.
Okay.
So first we're going to do side pass, but then we're going to pivot. So pivot, he's going to pivot on his left hind leg, and he's going to, his four legs are going to cross. He's going to have lateral pole flexion. His legs are going to cross. And when he pivots like this, he's going to have to reset his leg at either the corner point. When he gets to the corner point of a turn, he needs to reset because otherwise he twists his hocks.
Okay.
He's going to have some resetting. But right now, I need to review your half pass, your side pass, so I can see what's going to happen with the aids that you're going to give him, because side pass is the training aid for the pivot. So step him up.
And halt?
Yes, step him up to the halt. Okay, now his right hind leg is back, which is going to be problematic for half pass, because you have to side pass. Sorry. Okay, let's walk up again. In fact, let's move. I don't even want to do it here. One of the things you know about side pass and pivot is if you stand too long and they drop the thoracic, you move them again. So let's bring them up here and just halt straight and hesitate. And we're going to bend them left. Just going to have lateral pole flexion left. His forelegs are really uneven. Step up and halt. Do you have an aid for standing? Because most horses, we teach them that when we need them to stand, we need them to stand straight and time to that one hand touches their neck. So, yeah. I get that. But what I'm trying to talk to you about is a trainer. Can you please develop a signal for standing? Most of the world, including Germany, is if your hand touches their neck, they stand while it salutes. You put the left hand on their neck. So I'm trying to teach you, as a trainer, you need a signal. Get one.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm going to
get
it, but I'll get
one. Well, you're training everything else. Sitting there going, he isn't going to train it out. I'm going, come on, girl. You trained it out of the house. That's lame. I'm just saying. I don't know, but you can get this if you make up your mind. Okay, now you need to think about the side pass and that his head is going to be just barely to the left, and that you're going to swing his shoulders first, and you're going to keep this leg. Most trainers go a little forward and back and go sideways to get the side pass, because what I'm trying to get him to think about is when he starts the swing of the pivot, that he's going to move his shoulders. So you're going to use your thigh to get side pass, and you're going to use your lower leg, and you're going to focus on that it has to be parallel, cross his leg, and go this way. So can you go? Okay. So think about, you had your leg too far back, didn't you? Yeah, so let's start again. You look that way, and look up with your legs in your head. Look up. Yep. And think forward. Now pull on the reins. Yes. So pull on the reins back off a little and stop. Stop it. Not bad. Okay. Now, that is bad. And you begin to think about where your leg had to be and its shoulders to start first. Okay? Do you understand now how this is going to be important? Because you're going, oh my God, it's the front leg. You know, pivot, it's the front leg.
Okay.
So you're going, okay, I just got that. Okay, now you're going to turn it into a turn. So what you're going to do, the same thing, you're going to have a pole like this. You're going to think about where this leg has to be. Because what's going to happen is he has to do this with his front legs. Now what you want to do, you've got caterpillars, right? So you know, you've got a caterpillar wow when the instructor said to you, your seat was in the way. You know that feeling? Okay, can't do that. You gotta go, okay, I have to be in the position in a pirouette, but I can't sit down.
I can't sit down hard and I can't lean back. And I gotta keep my head level because if I drop my head, he's gonna back up. Because he has to keep forward thought because his legs have to pass in front of each other in the back. And these have to cross. All right, so you're gonna try to go like a quarter turn that way. And you're gonna start with his foreleg. So you turn your head like this. You look to see that his head is turning and you're trying to get him to go this way. Forward. Not yet. Okay, so you're going. That didn't work because my leg wasn't forward enough. Pivot, turn your head up. Turn your head up. Pull, hold, pull, hold. Okay, good. Now, I want you to side pass that way. Easy. Push the whip against his shoulder. Don't use his spur so much. Push, come on, legs forward. This right leg has to go in front of the other one. Yep, you almost pivoted, yes. Okay, now stop. Now easy, get off your butt. You're on your buttocks, lean forward. No, lean, look, he goes like this. Get off your buttocks. Okay, yeah, just crouch a little. Now lift up your head, go back. Yeah. Okay, now, easy. Oh,
step down.
Okay, now look.
Lunch.
No lunch. Nice job. So here, let's get away from those. Huh? Okay, now I want you to think about this. So when you're doing side pass, you whip on the shoulder and the leg here, and it's like push, push, push. So then when you're doing pirouette, it's forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. Because if you don't keep that hind leg, you have to, after a while, you're only going to indicate the forward, and you have to turn your belly button and your head for him to understand that he's gonna bring his forehand around. Yeah, oh, nice. Okay, you're getting there, all right? You'll get this. So the other thing to think about this is that you could do a whole lot more work in hand like we like to do a lot of work in hand, like step over, and we tell them, step over, step over, step over, step over, step over, and we do this back and forth, go around the other side. And we use the word, boy, those are nice, like those, step over. So once he knows step over, then side pass is like step over, step over. So that, you know, to get from side pass, we're using step over, and then when we turn our belly button, and you have to be sure you're not on your buttocks, and you cannot lean back. You almost have to crouch, and you have to be over your pubic bone. You cannot be on the back because they'll back up, which he does. So then you can, this is how you change the side pass aid to the pivot. So be clear with him. Which one are you doing? Because I don't know. Okay, then look towards me. Good, and go. Forward and back, you like, yeah, come on.
He's trying.
He's trying. Good, and good. Pet it, pet it, pet it. Okay, good. Okay, now you're just gonna, now, you know in walk pirouettes or canter pirouettes, you shake the rein just a little bit to keep them from progressing? Okay, so you just barely vibrate the rein while you pivot your stomach towards me and pivot him. Okay. Turn towards me, head. Hold, hold, hold. Yeah, you didn't get the leg planned.
No.
Okay, so now you're going to pivot leg. Turn harder, you. Turn. And just tell him, nope, nope, nope. See, what you did was you took your butt and you went against it. You went just like that and you shoved his right leg right out. What you have to do is you keep that leg on. Easy. You can't push with your seat against him. You'll push that leg out. So, can you move his shoulder just with your hands? Oh. Okay. So, you're going to have to guard more with your outside leg to keep that holding. So, guard with this leg. Oh. This one back a little. Okay. And when you move his shoulders, you're going to have to, this is a turn and forward, lean forward. And you're gonna go step, 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 step. That's better. It was better. Ho, 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 ho. Okay, step, ho, nice. Step, ho, ho, ho. Let me get a cookie. Don't do anything else. Bad end. And this is what we do. If someone helps, that's fine. If you do it on the ground, that's fine. It's great. I mean, he just pivoted both hind legs and went, okay, I went around. Nice job, bud. Okay, you'll get that. It's new, I get it.
Yeah.
But, it's coming, and he's got a talent for it. Good boy.